Drops de Ciência. Resumos de grandes notícias com cientistas e acadêmicos brasileiros, você confere aqui. Nos dias 30 de setembro e 1º de outubro, a Academia Brasileira de Ciências organizou o Simpósio Internacional Sociedade e Natureza, para promover um diálogo entre os cientistas sociais e da natureza sobre os atuais desafios à sustentabilidade. Em sua palestra de abertura, o físico Luiz Davidovich não só questionou esta aparente divisão entre as ciências e reforçou a importância de um melhor ensino científico à população, como também expôs uma visão peculiar sobre o trabalho e a motivação de um cientista.
I always find these divisions very strange, you know? Like if social was not social science were not natural, and natural science were not social. There are other possible divisions. People sometimes call about exact science. So that the others will be inexact, or maybe human science, and then my part will be inhuman, right? Exact science. Anyway, Lawrence Summers was the president of Harvard from 2001 to 2006. He mentioned in the program that it's a very interesting sentence, an educational culture where it is an embarrassment not to know the names of five plays by Shakespeare, but okay not to know the difference between a gene and a chromosome is not functional. So it's really a new view of culture, and I think it's a view of culture which we need in our contemporary world. In all these slides, I have mentioned science with this prospect of contributing to solve some big challenges that exist today for humankind. But I would like also to mention another side of science, which is a less utilitarian side of science. In the beginning of the 20th century, you have these bright young people here, were played with a new vision of nature, quantum physics. And in fact, they did not have any idea of the possible applications of that new view of nature. And they were moved really by curiosity, passion, and fascination. And yet, in the year 2001, an estimated 30% of the United States gross national product was based on inventions made possible by quantum mechanics. So, inventing the future has to do with that, has to do with science moved by passion, by curiosity.